Hey everybody, this is Kapalu. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I hope that you're having a wonderful morning thus far, or whatever time of day that it is that you're watching this video. I do hope and pray that things are going well for you, that you're feeling energized, that you're feeling refreshed, that whatever it is that you're striving to do, that it's happening for you, that you're making it happen, that you're continually rising to the top, that you're pushing away all of those obstacles and the fears and all of the naysayers and things that say you can't do what you need to do, or you can't do what you want to do, or all of that negative energy. I pray that you're pushing it away and far, far from you. I am so refreshed on today. I actually woke up this morning kind of tired and sluggish and feeling like sleeping in a little bit longer. And I had to get up and get going and take care of some things this morning. So I forced myself to get moving and doing that extra little bit to get myself up and moving around the house. And, you know, just like that, in a moment's time, you know, I was up and moving around and doing all that I needed to do in the shower, you know, getting the dog out, just getting dressed, all of that. So here I am on my way out. And I just wanted to stop and do a quick video to my YouTubers, just to encourage you on today. This week, I want to share something with you. This week, I've been in a seminar with a course that's teaching Revelation, Eschatology, the End Times. And it has been so good. And, you know, I'm a student, Bible student, so I love studying the Word of God and getting, you know, drawn from it. And it's been so interesting reading about the things that are to take place after the rapture and during the tribulation and into the millennium. And when you realize all that is coming ahead, what the world is going to face if and when they do not accept Christ, they are in for horrible, tragic, demonic, unlike any other time in history that we can look back on and in that's been recorded. I mean, the world is in for terrible, terrible times. And it just really behooves us to share the good news with our loved ones, to let people know what they must do to be saved, and that we want to draw them in so that we can have our loved ones and the like to be with us in eternity. If you have made a profession and a confession in Christ, then you won't have to worry about being here during the tribulation. But, I mean, when you look at this, the current events and all that is going on, the Middle East and the way the economic times are measuring up, you can really see the setting being made for the Antichrist to come on the scene and for mankind to be completely deceived and denied the truth of God, you know. So it's just really, it's just been a very good seminar this week. I just wanted to share that with you. And hopefully encourage you to, you know, get into your Bible more, pray more, study more, so that you can be aware of the signs and the things to look for. The Bible doesn't want us, you know, to be deceived. God doesn't want us to be deceived or to be ignorant of the things that are coming. They're there for us to know and to be aware of, so that we can know how to prepare for them, that we might know how to keep our guard up, and then educate ourselves, be approved, so that we don't be, so that we're not drawn into the fold of them that will be deceived. It said even the very elect can be deceived because of the power that's going to come on the scene in the form of the Antichrist, the false prophet, and the beast. So, I just wanted to drop that in your spirits on today, you know, something to think about. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Certainly, I want you to have a blessed day today, a blessed evening, night, afternoon, whatever time of day it is that you're listening to this. And know that inside of you lies such power, such richness, such authority that you can overcome that thing or that entity or whatever it is that's causing you to be stagnant, fall behind, or hindered. You can do all things through Christ who gives you strength. So don't say you can't. Don't give up on yourself. Don't stop believing and trusting in Christ who can do all things but fail. So I just wanted to say that on the day. Prayerfully, somebody's encouraged. I know I'm encouraged just by hearing it. I have to say things to myself. I have to talk to myself all the time because the enemy can be so strong. You know, you hear so much in the world around you, you know, noise, just noise from people talking and the TV and the radio and just the hustle and bustle of the everyday life. You can get caught up. And if you're not careful, if we're not careful, we can be drawn in. So I just want you to keep on doing the right thing, the good things, feeding your spirit. I'm not so super saved that I can't laugh or that I don't like to have fun, that I can't keep it real, that I don't like to listen to regular music sometime within reason. As a matter of fact, I got something on my page right now that I really like. It's one of my featured videos. I like this song, so I've been playing it on my page. But, you know, I say that to say this. I'm a real person, a human being with natural fleshly issues. And to combat those natural fleshly issues, I have to stay in prayer. I have to stay in confession before the Lord, asking Him to forgive me daily. And then I have to repent. And you know, we walk this journey, we run this race, and we try to strive continually to be pleasing before the Lord and to one day find ourselves in His presence. And that's where I want to be, and I want to see you there. So, guys, just be encouraged. Love on yourselves today. Love on God. Continue to trust and believe that He loves you, that He wants the best for you, that He has a purpose and a plan for your life, and that you can make it. I don't care where you are, what you're doing, what you're going through, you can make it. The only thing that will deprive you or deny you from making it is the enemy that will sow seeds and plant thoughts in your mind that you can't do it. So let's put that out of our mind today. Let's not let that rent any space in our minds. Let's just believe that we're overcomers by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. God be with you. Go with God, and I promise He'll go with you. Be blessed on today. Thanks for watching.